I'm not saying that it's not deserving, that we should be pessimistic, but we should come to a point where when your president tells you, when people around the president and the president tells you, he's okay, thank you for your prayers, we should look at it from the more positive point that it's not about being major. I don't know about his illness, whether it's major or not. Yes, there may be complications in terms of the checks. Doctors want to see something more specific. So we should just pray that, whatever they come up with, it's not something devastating. But that people want to do further checks, it means they haven't seen anything. They just want to make sure. That's my interpretation. But then again, it could be what you say. But even if that is the case, perhaps maybe yes, the government needs to be a little bit more forthcoming. But even if the government is more forthcoming, Nigerians should just sit back, pray, and hope. But what is most important, like I said, the wheels of governance is still grinding. It's still rolling. It's a different thing if it had come to a stop, like it did in the last during Yar'Adua's time. So what we have now is all speculation. Now, if the image, now don't forget that prior to now, the first thing was that this president was dead. Then it became the president was dying. Then it became the president was in a coma. Then it became the president has lost all his senses. Then it became, and each time this was proven to be wrong, they'll come up with something else. Oh, these are old pictures. Oh, these are pictures that are photoshopped. Let's get out of that. Yes, we should be concerned. I'm concerned, but not concerned to the extent that I'll start coming up with stories.
You're a major representative of the people, and you know what people could feel like. Some people have said, if the president would have been speaking with people and meeting with people, then he should be strong enough to talk to Nigerians. Do you think that by now, maybe in some conference call, sort of, should send a message out to Nigerians, and a video message and a voice message, so that the confidence will come back? A lot of people say they've lost that.
Yeah, I mean, I would do it. I would advise him to do it if I was in a position to advise him. But the fact that he hasn't done it does not mean that that he's doing something wrong. People have different approaches. And don't forget that recently, just about a week ago, the Mr. President spoke to a congregation in Kano State, where made to understand. He was audible, he was clear, it was his voice, he was a doctored. To answer your question, that may as well be him speaking to Nigerians. But I would do it differently. I quite agree with you. I would do it differently. My approach may have been different. Because, yes, it has generated a lot of talk, a lot of concern, like you said. And therefore, if it has generated so much, I would wish the president would talk to everybody as opposed to talk to, you know, individuals here and there.
He's out. The speaker and the deputy speaker were on the team that went to see the president in London. Have they briefed the House of Representatives about what they found out and the trip to London to see the president?
I believe that briefing has been done individually and collectively through zonal briefings.
There's not been any official briefing from those two principal officers to the House on the floor.
Well, not on the floor.
Not officially.
Not on the floor. But official, the way we work in the House of Representatives, you can call it caucus, different caucuses in smaller groups. It becomes official. It's always better to do something one time in a group, and it makes it even more official because the floor, and that's where you have the mace, and that gives it that official done. But to the extent that you call a caucus, perhaps Southwest, perhaps Northeast, or whatever caucus, and you tell them, this is what happened, even individually. It may not be official, but you've basically reported your findings. That is not to say, perhaps it might have been better to have called to briefed us at plenary. And again, you must also understand one thing. This is a very delicate matter. I do not know that the Speaker and Deputy Speaker, I'm not sure, but I do not think that they went officially on behalf of the House, because there was no such resolution in the House. So they went in their personal capacity out of concern. And also they are the head of the Speaker is the head of the presiding officers. So is there an obligation thereafter to now come and brief the whole House collectively? If the whole House, if there was no official mandate or the resolution for them to go, then it becomes, you know, it's neither here nor there. Whether, I mean, I could go to try and see the President tomorrow in my official capacity, in my personal capacity. It doesn't mean I'll come back to the House and brief the House. I will brief people who ask me. So let's not make too much about that. The point to be made is that they saw Mr. President. He looked good. He talked good. He was well. They've said it to the whole world. They went even beyond official. They said it to the whole world. The Speaker tweeted it. He said it in the papers. That's even more than official. He's telling the whole world. He put his credibility on the line. And that's why I believe him. Just like the VP put his credibility on the line. And I believe the VP.
Well, that's the first part of the interview we had with Honorable Femi Badjabiamila. But we'll take a moment. And when we return, more on that interview with the leader of the House of Representatives, the promise by President Muhammadu Buhari in the 2017 budget. Is the budget padded now? Find out after the break.